Here at BYU, in the holography group, we are working to create the displays of science fiction. Displays like the holodeck from Star Trek or the Princess Leia projector from Star Wars. So most displays, including 3D displays, require you to look at a screen. But our technology creates images that are floating out in space, and they're physical. The way our new optical trap technology works is that we have a laser beam. It traps a little particle in the air, and then that beam moves around and it drags that particle around with it. And if we move it fast enough, we will see the entire image all at once. Most of these images we created were done with long exposures. We rastered out an image over time. Today, we're able to actually create simple animations. Here are two toys small enough to fit in our current display volume. So they are teeny tiny. This dot is a trapped particle. So it's being held by an invisible laser beam, illuminated by a visible laser beam, to form the outline of an explosion. Here we see the particle moving back and forth rapidly as it's illuminated to give the effect of a phaser blast or a disruptor charge moving back and forth between the ships. What you're seeing in this scene is real. There is nothing computer generated about it. These are real lasers moving around in space between these two ships. So unlike the movies, where the lightsabers never really existed in physical space, these are actual luminous beams rising from these lightsabers. So this is still just one particle drawing both these lightsaber beams. It's just moving fast enough that it can change location and change color. And it would happen in real time as the battle was occurring. And we've used our display to draw in the air a little stick figure. So here we have our stick man walking across the surface of a student's finger. We did want to show how this type of image could interact with a human. A volumetric display, like our display, is different than other types of 2D and some 3D displays in that it doesn't have a screen. Because our images are made from glowing particles inside a fixed volume, we can really only draw images inside that volume.
So if, for example, I wanted to display a mountain and I wanted it to look like the size of a real mountain, I would have to build a volumetric display the size of a mountain.
In our most recent research, we are trying to create images that exist outside our drawing volume. What we've done is we've taken a very small 3D printed house. What we're trying to do is to make the moon look like it exists outside the drawing volume by making that moon track the viewer. We are moving the camera, and we're also moving that moon image that we're drawing in the air in synchrony, so it gives the impression that it's behind the house when in fact it's being drawn in front of the house.
We can play some fancy tricks with motion parallax, and we can make the display look a lot bigger than it physically is. This methodology would allow us to create the illusion of a much deeper display up to kind of theoretically an infinite size display, and that's all by changing the image as the viewer translates through the scene.
We now have the opportunity, as our images get bigger, to create experiences for the viewer that are beyond our drawing volume. We can create environments that are outside rooms or beyond windows using this technique.